consistently, he would be, like, number one in the world.
And Switch is also the biggest Gala fan.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like
he loves
take
the
this
guy.
All in mind saying, Switch is hella biased.
Switch probably wants Gala to win this match, even though he's playing. Like, he's going to try his best to win. But
he's going to put on a good match.
He's
going to
be rooting for Gala.
All right, my hat gets super sideways with these mics. I need to figure this out. Yeah, every time I look into that player cam, I'm like, how is my hat that far sideways right now? But that's what the
this has been an amazing tournament so far. It was quite a really nice venue.
Yep. It's off to a slow start, but we are ramping it up. The train is left to the gates.
This grand finals. I mean, this is kind of what the people want. These are two of a lot of people's favorite players. Like, a lot of people love these players, love to watch them. They're both, like, kind of innovators of their character.
Oh, yeah. No, this is the best Mario in the business and the best Wolf to ever do it.
Yeah. One of the only Wolves to ever do it, ever since Chillin' Dude.
I mean, we don't mention Chillin' Dude for Wolf.
Might be.
Let's be real.
Yo, might be.
I love every time a, like, Switch combo is posted, not to the PM subreddit, but to the normal Smash subreddit. At least, like, one or two people would be like, yeah, but is he better than Chillin'? It's like, yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
There's no contest. Like, clearly.
It's not close.
Yep. Switch. Chillin' gets beaten by Marshall.
Ooh.
And, like, I love Marshall. I love that dude. But I think Switch could probably take that one.
Switch, would you say Switch is top 15 in the world? Or top 40? It's hard to tell. There's so much talent out there.
I'd say because you got Malachi. Are we counting Lunchables still?
He said he quit, but he still goes to things.
He goes to things, but then he sandbags.
True.
Like, kind of. He'll get to a certain point, and then he'll sandbag.
Which is sad, because he was an amazing player to watch.
I mean, like, if your heart's not in it, you just don't feel it anymore. Okay, it is 7 minutes,
okay.
30 seconds.
I'm going to be honest,
and I'd say
I thought this was hand warmers, and then they started edge guarding.
No. Like, it's 7 minutes, 30 seconds in the game, and a majority of it's taking place off stage.
Yeah. They have not spent a lot of time on stage, and now they're back off stage again. And that back air was so clean.
Mario does a swan dive off, shows him his toes.
Oh, no.
Okay.
And the homie stock.
I was going to say, if anybody is going to say Gallo, you know what? I'm going to SD because you SD'd.
If anyone's going to give the homie
it's Switch.
Especially because he SD'd at 0%. Like,
yep.
Switch doesn't want to take that. A lot of players would take that. Philly PM, we take
Switch,
those.
Switch would
does
take
not.
That against any other player.
I think so.
Any other player. But if you are a Gallo fanboy, you're not going to lose to Gallo on something like that.
Yeah. You don't, like, a lot of times you don't want to take a win off some BS like that. But sometimes you got it. But
I
in
mean,
a situation like this, where they play.
If this
I
was
like
Olympus, he'd probably take it.
I feel like they play quite a bit back
in
New York.
They do.
And so, in a situation like this, it's just like, whatever, dude, you can have that stock. But it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
With taking almost no percent.
After that stock is done, I'm going hard in the paint.
With almost no percent, he took that stock so clean.
What? How did Wolf end up on that side? There was a weird, like, forward smash dash attack interaction.
And Gallo's combos, we talk about Switch's combos being really good, but Gallo's combos are also quite insane.
Gallo's got
misses
those
that
Italian
back air,
plumber
though.
Combos, though.
Yeah. Gallo's kind of got to wrench them together, you know, make sure they're all, like, cleaned out. Then
he
gets them. But that's going to take game one. A two-stock by Switch.
Swings his giant fist.
Not only was it would have been a three-stock, but he took that stock for Gallo.
It's true.
So think about that. He really only lost one stock to Gallo.
Lost one stock to Gallo, one stock to himself. And there's suitably upbeat music for such a time like this.
Smashville, of course. 3, 2. Well, I know it's a big joke, like Smashville is the NBA thing, but everyone loves Smashville. I do not know a single person who does not.
Most of this tournament has taken place on Smashville.
I can't think of a single person who
hates
Smashville.
Someone hit me with those PM stats. Like, what percentage of games take place on Smashville? In top 8. Let's just go top 8.
Even like, what percentage of game 1s of a set are on Smashville? Probably a majority. Smashville or Battlefield are like the two stages that are always gone
to. I see PS2 more in PM.
Oh, really?
Than Battlefield, not than Smashville.
Oh, okay.
I think I started both for
that fireball. Oh! That edge guard was so clean. Who needs to grab ledge
fireball
when you can just swag all over him? give him that work.
When does swag start to become optimal?
When you do it like that.
When does it become just style?
When you fireball into a back air to edge guard. And Switch could have teched it, but I don't think he was ready. Like,
no.
Nobody
would
was ready.
Would you have been ready?
No.
Would anybody have been ready?
No.
Like, this is not
sure.
That's just
not
something we're ready for.
I'm not even sure if Gallo was ready. Let's be real.
Like, what? Can Gallo create an edgeguard so bad that Gallo himself cannot tech it? Like, we're getting really existential here.
It's on that meta where it's just like, you're so far in like your opponent's head that even you don't know what's going on. Is that twice? He teched it that time. He teched that one. Oh my, wait, what? Did you see how hard he mashed that down B?
I want to point out that before that entire thing happened, Gallo just like turned around 8 times.
Yeah.
Like all he did was spin 8 times
and
then
Switch
go for
just sat in shield because he was so scared. He didn't know what was going to happen.
It's not even dash dancing. It was, I'm just going to turn a bunch of times.
I think walking is a bit scarier than dashing sometimes in this game. Walking is broken. You can do everything out of
the
ball.
He wasn't walking though. He stayed in the same spot.
Standing
he
still,
was stationary.
Standing still almost just as broken as walking. You can do everything out of walk. You can do everything out of standstill.
It's true, but sometimes I question your like fundamental theories of the game.
I mean, I was taught by a kid who knows nothing about the game, so...
Yeah, what's a RAR?
What can you expect? However, these guys know a lot about the game, as you can see from the play. They're pulling
I'm
out
sure
every
they know
trick.
Plenty about RAR.
They're pulling out every
Ooh,
trick in
that's
the
That's gonna get you shield grabbed all day,
oh
every
my God.
Day!
Oh my lord!
So, if you rewind that, you see he missed the forward air in on...
But then when Switch got up, he did another forward air into a jab reset into an S-smash. Or was it a jab reset into
it was,
a forward
no, air? No, it was jab reset into forward air into
okay,
S-smash.
My bad, I got the order mixed up. Those three moves still happened in some sequence. That was sick.
It was... I know it was these moves, but in what order?
I'm surprised how high that hit of downer went, actually. I wonder if he was, like, SDIing up a bit or just, like, holding up. I was
oh,
surprised
crouch
to see how
cancels that forward smash.
Yeah, I'm surprised it actually didn't like put him in knockdowns.
Well,
of times
he was
like,
after the forward smash hit, he was at 23%.
True.
So he was.
I was accidentally looking at Mario's percent.
He was sitting.
So
no, it does not.
Kobe,
matter.
Wait, what? He lived?
Okay, Switch.
I thought Gal just had the sickest Kobe SD kill, and then Switch was like, no. You can't swagger me like that. That F tilt was so smart.
Kobe, yeah, it's he's going for those Jordan dunks from half court. Doesn't work when your character can fly.
You can't dunk like Jordan when your opponent is Shaquille O'Neal.
You can't dunk like Jordan when your opponent's wearing Air Force Ones. Like.
Yo. But that won't get it. The Kobe right there, taking that stock. Taking game two, actually. Up 2-0.
Sometimes you go for a dunk and sometimes you go for that clean
1-1? Oh, that's right.
Shot.
Switch to game one. My bad. So,
yeah,
I was confused. But I don't know, just because
Respect
of
the switch,
because of how
on.
Good Gallo played, I just assumed he took the first game. Because of how dominant he was.
Gallo played so well that he took the last game, too.
He took it back.
We went back in time, took that game, and then went back forward again.
So game two.
We've got Back to the Future going on.
Yeah. Back
Gallo's
back.
Gallo's winning games retroactively after they happen.
It's like, you beat me so bad, I'll give you the last game, too. You know, you earned it. back to Smashville.
Switch Go. Literally is yelling to the crowd what his Twitter is right now. So follow him at Switch SSB. It is a shame that one of the best players in our game does not have that many followers.
He follows back though, so
he does follow back.
What a legend! And he'll retweet stuff like he's actively following back.
Yeah, he's not one of those like I have 75,000 followers and I follow 50,000.
Ooh, the cape really smart because it got rid of that back end.
Celebrities.
Honestly, oh no. Wait, okay, no. He
just
ledge.
Got stage spiked by Shine.
Yeah, and then...
This move is broken. Capital B-R-O.
It's good. He's really caving a lot because he sees Switch going for those back airs, and he just turns it away.
I
wonder if Switch...
I don't want to get hit by that, so...
I wonder if Switch is going to... Oh my god, that sock was sick.
I got
sick.
The medical cape.
I wonder if Switch is going to start mixing that up and back airing away from him. Because I've seen people do that in, like, Melee against Mario's. Yep.
I
would not
that,
be surprised.
But Switch is up 2 stocks.
Yeah.
Does he need to? Like, it may be smart, but are we on another level right now?
You'll take every advantage you can get in these kinds of games. And when Gallo is doing the same thing from ledge, which is tournament winner cape, like...
Tournament winner cape is the secret meta.
He's been doing it every time, though. He hasn't really mixed it up that much.
Switch just stood in shield for, like, a solid 6 seconds.
He's, like, that's kind of, like, the top player fear. And also, I think he might just be... He's respecting...
Switch isn't going to sit in shield versus me like that.
He's respecting Gallo a bit too much.
Oh, yeah.
And, like...
I wanted to see just grab after grab after grab. Oh, he's going for that fireball edge guard again.
Yeah. And that worked the last time, but I think Switch has kind of become aware of it. Oh, that back there with the not the best DI going to cause it to kill. At quite an early percent. I believe after he was hit, he was at 90.
We heard the yell.
Yeah, and like, saw the little poof, but the DI was good enough.
But apparently, we are still living there.
Oh, he just missed that ledge grab to steal that ledge from Switch.
Luckily, Mario got back to the platform and wasn't just, like, brutally sent to the depths.
Yeah, luckily, he was at, like, 0%, so it did not send too far. Yeah. It was not a big deal. Ooh, I like this combo's looking really clean. But Gal is able to switch it around with the chain grab. Ooh, that plat drop up air. So clean. Is he just going to side your arm? Okay.
I was like, we're just kind of waiting.
It was like waiting for something to happen.
There was a moment for the crowd to breathe. Yeah. And then he's like, all right, Bear. Let's go.
And actually, Gao's been catching a lot of people with those cape stalls. But now Switch is starting to call them out.
The cape stalls,
he's doing them at like similar places. So it's kind of easy to call him out. Just go where he is and not where he's going to be.
Who better to call out the cape stalls than Gao's biggest fan?
Yeah. Gao's biggest fan's got to know how he plays. He watches him all the time and cheers him on. If you're the biggest fan of someone, you probably know them better than anyone else.
Yep. It's like when you go to a concert and the entire crowd is singing along and the lead singer hasn't started yet.
Yeah.
You're like, I love you so much, I know what you're going to do anyways.
Yeah, Switch is singing along to Gallo's playstyle and Gallo hasn't even started his moves. He's like, you're going to cape now. And then 2 seconds later, Gallo's like, I'm going to cape.
This tour has gone on too long. We need a new
one. Oh, my lord. That's going to be the stock, I think. No, he has a jump. I didn't think he had a jump back.
Nope. But we're going to rinse and repeat.
Yeah. He's still off stage. I think he has a jump back. Yep.
We're going to rinse and repeat. Rub-a-dub-dub.
Oh, actually, he went a bit too high above the ledge, which, I mean, usually would work. But Switch, with that awareness, that's, again, he's just moving back and forth, and Switch is just sitting in shield.
I thought for a second we were going to see Switch go from being comboed to comboing.
And he was, and he had the tech chase, actually, but he didn't follow up on it.
Like, most games, after a combo ends, there's like a bit of neutral play, and then another combo starts, and these guys are like, oh,
D.I. Joe is back, ladies
and gentlemen.
D.I. Joe is back from the dead, and now he has been killed again.
Is that like... So I know, obviously I know G.I. Joe. Does that like happen? Is it like the Marvel comics where people just die and come back?
I'll be honest, I know absolutely nothing about G.I. Joe.
All I know is like G.I. Joe and then we sing American Hero and he plays Cobra.
There was a movie with The Rock. That's all I got.
I should watch that movie. I'm sure it's not good.
Everything with The Rock is amazing. Switch, The Rock.
What? No. No.
Giving him the Cold Stone Stunner.
We have made enough names for Switch. We don't need to call him The Rock.
The Nintendo Switch with that flash.
Yeah, sponsored by Nintendo themselves.
We wish.
There was a day where... There was a moment in time where everyone who played PM was like, yeah, we're on the main stage. And now we're like, okay. Like, we got our own
tournaments. This is the main stage of... Yeah, we have our own tournaments now.
We are here and we are living.
And it's sick.
It is sick. This is one of my favorite gaming
games. Oh my lord! These tech chases! Side
shine, dare, shine, dare, shine, dare! I'm dead off the side!
He misses the shorten. He was going for the shorten, I can tell, but he missed it just so much that he didn't.
Sometimes you get so hyped that you just kill yourself, and that's what happens.
And also, that shorten timing is very strict.
Sometimes you love your own combos that much.
Oh, and not the best DI causes a zero to death at like 60% too. But that'll take it right there.
And we are
4% on Switch.
He could 4%.
One more stock, and there's a reset. We could get a bracket reset and have...
I want a bracket reset.
It would be sick.
Real talk.
This set is insane.
Now, these guys have played a lot, so this probably goes somewhere in their top 10 sets of all time.
Yeah. I'm sure Switch is loving every moment of it. And I'm sure Gallo is too.
Yeah, no, we talk about Switch being a huge Gallo fan, but real talk, it's a
My lord, that side B kill.
And we got a reset. Let's start the thing over.
Yeah.
Guys, the tournament starts anew.
Switch.
Instead of a bracket reset, we should just be like, oh, well, he reset grand. It's time to start from round one again.
New tournament.
And
we're back
day
in.
Two.
Day two.
But it's just Switch waiting in grands. It's like one person gets a really easier beginner's to run.
A lot of people don't understand why they do bracket resets.
And it's because it's double elimination.
Yeah, it's basically because it's double elimination. So, like, the person who's in winner side hasn't lost yet.
Yep.
So, if they lose one, it's not fair to kick them out.
It's not. It's not a. It's not like who did. Well, it is who did you beat, but it's who did you beat, or who did you not lose to?
Yeah.
I can't talk now. Because you don't lose once, but you lose twice. And now both of these guys have an L to their name.
Yep. Which means the next set decides this tournament.
Two, one. I mean, yeah. Go. That's literally what this means.
I have a very strong feeling that these guys are likely splitting the pot here, so I don't think there's money on the line,
nah.
So they can play at their full potential.
No. Switch is looking to upgrade his Switch fan. He wants to pay it. He actually, like, I know there was a GoFundMe and everything, but he also still has to pay people back that gave him, like, loans so he could get his fan fixed, because those things cost a lot of money. Switch is looking to reinvent the Switch fan. He's probably gonna get some nice, like,
some sick rims.
He's probably gonna upgrade the
some
stereo
hydraulics
on it.
It's gonna be bouncing down the street.
We're going for that, like, vinyl wood paneling.
Oh, gonna get some rocker phosphate speakers going in there.
Is that a thing?
I think so. Pretty sure that's like an 80s or 90s thing.
Oh, okay. Let's just describe the ultimate 90s fan. It's got carpet. It's a shag carpeting.
Oh my lord.
But instead of a sedan, it's the Switch van.
Speaking of the ultimate van, Switch took him for a ride around the stage to finish off that combo. Oh my lord.
Such a dumb segue.
I had to get back to the match side.
I know. We've described an imaginary van long enough.
Time to make a U-turn back to this commentary. Let's go. That S-Smash read was actually really smart.
That S-Smash read didn't just cover the roll, but it also covered tech and
Tech and Tech. Covered 3 out of 4 options. And option coverage is such a big part of this game. Like, a lot of times, you'll, like, leave one option open, but if you can cover the most options, the other person isn't always thinking about what options you're going to cover.
Okay, not only did we get a double dunk, but Gallo goes, all right, and then edge cancels a fair into another fair while waiting for Switch to get off the Angel Pod.
Switch is doing some cool shit, but, like, Gallo is also insane at this game. We talk about Switch a lot, but that's just because Wolf is flashy and really exciting to watch, but Gallo's Mario... Yeah.
Gallo's Mario is on another level. He's not on 1-1 anymore. He's definitely on, like, 5-3 at least.
He definitely took the warp zone real quick.
Yup. Gallo got to that, 1-3 with the warp zone and goes, all right, let's at least level up quick here.
Oh, that down air is going to fall up. And Gallo's teching all of these really well, which is sometimes hard to do. So that's really impressive, actually. The fact that he's able to react so quickly in tech. A lot of, like, newer players will miss those, and they won't be ready for it.
Wait, don't you for a minute imagine that these guys are new. No. And like the game before this, we're back down to that one stock. This is still anyone's game.
But Switch has the momentum.
Sick reads.
And Switch is getting these really long combo strings with insane reads.
He still hasn't really been touched. Okay, there he goes.
There he goes. But is Gallo
starting
to turn
thing.
Around the combo? No, Switch still has him in disadvantage. He's keeping pressure on Gallo. Even when Gallo is hitting him, like, it feels like Switch still has, like, an advantage and still has pressure on him. Because Gallo's kind of hitting him out of desperation, and Switch is hitting him out of aggression.
Mario alternates between being, like, a magician with his cape and then being, like, a basketball legend.
He's like,
Like, we've got Michael Jordan and, crap.
He's a bull wrestler.
What?
Olé! They're going to the ledge, and he goes, Olé! And they go the other way.
I mean, yeah, okay.
Is this going to be... Oh, he makes it back to stage. I actually didn't think he was high enough up to make that. I really thought that was about to be the game when Switch screen grab.
Oh, both of those shields looking so low.
You got to watch your shield, Gallo. Switch's shield pressure is actually really incredible right now. Oh, not quite able to make it back. Good stuff to Gallo on that game, actually. Really able to clutch it out.
Jeez, Mario's wind noise was, like, super loud there. I don't know if it's been that loud the entire time, but I noticed it that one.
We've heard Mario's wind noise once. It's been a while. Switch took a lot. Switch took
a bunch in a row. Yeah. Stereo Kid is yelling at Boyko.
There's rules against coaching, guys.
If you notice, Boyko's face is in the frame.
Coaching is banned here.
Is it? No, it's not.
It's in the rules. We just read it, actually. It's at the bottom of the page.
Is coaching entirely banned?
It just says as long as it doesn't, like, interrupt like the next match or like.
Well, this isn't.
What's like it isn't. Like I know it's fine. I'm just like joking around. But
oh,
I'm
don't
saying,
tell
like,
the people at home that believe you. You are wearing a headset, therefore you need to be a paragon of truth.
I mean, it is banned, but like, not, it's like.
So is this game.
True. You're right. Might be. Legalize.
Legalize PM, please.
PM on the Switch. Switch on the Switch.
Okay, I based on like the way Nintendo is functioning right now, if we're getting like Smash 4 on Switch eventually, we're gonna have like Smash 4 for Switch with the GameCube controller adapter for Wii U. Like it's gonna be like four different platforms all added in.
Let's see what Switch can do with Battlefield. I actually think Wolf. I personally think Wolf does really well on Battlefield because he's able to extend his combos a bit more. And his down smash covers the full platform. So if he does a downer onto the platform and they tech, he can cover every option. It's almost like a Game Watch down throw on platforms. It's like, it covers everything.
Oh, no, it is so good. For anybody, if anybody's watching this right now and they're saying, I kind of forgot that PM was a thing, I would love to join. Your local scene is popping, and if it's not, get it going.
The Big West, East Coast, West Coast,
they're all still playing.
You can
South.
Find groups on Facebook. There's stuff in the Midwest, even like just like small regions have good players.
Minneapolis is a poppin' region. Like, we got it going. But also, the reason I was thinking about this is Mario is a great character to learn on. He heavily encourages fundamentals in the learning. But
yes.
Don't mistake this for being just fundamentals, because this is a flashy, smart.
Ooh, I like the cape option there. It really it covered two ledge and straight
corner.
Ahead.
Like,
ooh,
how many
be...
times does Gallo need to win tournaments for him to get his PhD? When does he go from Mario to Dr. Mario? When is he Mario with $40,000 in student loans?
He loves his job as a plumber too much to become a doctor.
Also, when does Mario ever do actual plumbing?
The cartoon.
But we don't talk about that. So, Switch gets a grab! Yeah, back throw!
I think you can react to back throw. But
the thing is, that was a throw mix-up. He was waiting for a down throw, and that's why he went for the DI.
What a lot of people will do against Wolf is they'll hold DI for the down throw and then try to react to the back throw.
Yep. But if you do it fast enough, it's still hard.
It's really, I'm not saying it's easy in any sense.
It's reactable, but it's hard.
Especially if you immediately throw, like, you're not ready.
Yep. And not only does Switch vary his throw timings, but... Sorry, he not only does he vary his throws, but he varies his throw timings.
Yeah, which can really, like, mix you up. Yep. Which makes him super hard. Sometimes he'll throw a pummel in as well. And then when he's pummeling, then you're just thinking about mashing and not really DI.
Mario looking for that lunch money, saying...
Oh, is that
going to
take it?
Yep, it's taking
it off
the top.
Whoa, that stock was insane by Switch. The control he has over this stage right now. It's just the momentum he's carrying. The crowd in the game is behind him.
Listen.
They're howling.
The crowd, when they have Wolf, they are howling for him.
Ooh, I like that up the shield, actually.
Oh, yeah.
He was trying to catch a shield grab by Switch. And the cape. Olé!
Yep. No, Mario's up B is a great escape option. It comes out fast. If you hit, it pushes the person away. You get some quick lunch money for it. And if you miss, it still bounces off the shield, and you can actually use it to either edge cancel when you land or land on the ledge itself. It's such a good move, like, option once you know how to use it well.
Oh, I like that combo, but it does not kill. If he had gotten the sweet spot, that would have been over. No.
I'm still expecting him to get this edge guard, though.
Oh, wow. I thought he was going to drop back air, but he just kind of let him get back.
And he's scared. What?
Did he try to go for shine back air?
I think he was expecting a different DI.
Possibly. You can DI shine quite hard, and it really changes up the angle you go.
Now, Wolf does have phenomenal options for almost every kind of DI, but most players are expecting a couple of different ones. Yeah. They're not ready to react to all the different ways you can DI shine. It's not like a Fox Shine that always gets that knockdown or always gets that, like, depending on the weight, obviously. Sometimes some characters are knocked down like Marth, or some characters you've got that Peach-esque wave shine. It's not like Falco, where it sends straight up no matter what you're getting.
It
has
a
weird
diagonal,
like diagonal, and that's what he's looking for. We are consulting Stereo Kid pretty often after this. He is right behind Switch's mane, those luscious locks, and so you can't see him at all until he moves. But that's the
thing. Stereo Kid also put on quite a good show today. I believe he got three.
Oh, yeah. Stereo Kid's a legend, though. One. Like, he's not as active anymore, but you still got it.
Yeah.
There was a long time that he was in, like, contention for being number one Ness, actually. Right now, it looks like Jose V is kind of running with that. But if Stereo Kid starts becoming active again, I could see him.
Oh, I like that.
Oh!
Oh, my God, that's it.
That was...
Why did you drop that? He could have just held ledge. But he'll make it back because Mario's got wall jumps.
There was a lot of things happening off stage.
I really thought
I got
just
really
hold
excited
ledge.
And nothing happened.
Yeah, that edge guard would have
been
sick.
I am upset. Yeah. I wanted a really cool kill.
But this combo could still go. No. Nice DI by Switch and then rolls in to get away from Mario. That should be it though. Up throw fair. Solid kill. Really good kill confirmed for Mario.
Oh, that was like the cape out of short hop. Sometimes you
Gao is using these capes in neutral in ways that I don't see any other Marios really do.
The thing is, I want him to like clean that up just a little bit. He's actually getting punished, like, not all the time, but a decent amount of time, he's getting punished for the lag that cape puts you in if it misses.
Oh, that sweet spot fair is not quite going to take the stop. Next one, like, if he gets another one of those, if he gets another combo string into, like, a big hit, that's going to be it. Mario's at a kill percent. However, he takes that second stock before Switch can take one.
Up. Grand final set two, and while this has been going back and forth, this is looking like Gallo's getting a power-up from the Sunshine stage.
However, we have seen a lot of comebacks in this set alone.
Oh, we've seen a ton of comebacks.
In this tournament, too.
The last two times that Gallo has been recovering on, like, he's been going low and going for that double jump, or that wall jump. So Switch needs to start looking out for that.
I mean, it's a very hard thing to cover, too.
Because
he can change up where
he just did
like,
it again. That's three times in a row now. I know it's hard to cover, but if someone's that consistent, you gotta respect
You gotta figure out something. I mean, he's doing the right thing by grabbing ledge so Gallo can't go there. But Mario doesn't have, like, a really big amount of end lag.
It is fast. If you grab ledge and then roll up, Mario's already on stage.
Yeah, and he's probably out of end lag already. End lag is not very big for that move. Ooh, I like the fade back on the ledge. Really
I was
good.
A little worried that he was going to get that cape out in time.
Laser there instead of going for a back air. Interesting idea.
He went for an ally. It's like, you're standing behind me. Let me just up smash anyways.
Ooh,
how many fireballs? I was going to say.
It's taking up so much space, too. It's almost like a Samus missile. It's just like everywhere on the stage.
Oh,
he missed the
fireball
side
is not just to get the hit. Yes, he wants the hit so that
you can hit into certain things and it can take his jump and it can kind of interrupt his upbeat.
That was two lasers in a row. Capes back. What I was going to say, though.
Oh, I love that. That was beautiful.
Fireball off stage, if he hits, it's similar to like a Falco laser where you're forcing your opponent to recover from lower. But the fireballs are also taking up space so that you're cutting off recovery options.
Like that. Right there.
Exactly what I'm talking about. And then that is the stop.
That edge guard was phenomenal.
That was clean.
Every time Switch tried to do something, he's like, all right, block.
We were talking
block.
Like Windex on window. Like, that was clean.
First fireball on
like,
the
look
side
at them. This is
another day
at
the park.
Friends.
Like, you know, just hanging out.
Like, they both want the W. They want to win, but they're going to have a blast. Well, they love
and no matter who wins, they're going to be happy for them. No one's going to be salty after this.
Well, I mean, they are in free saltiness, but... Whoa, crouch canceled the shine that got crouch canceled.
Crouch canceling is a very good tool in this game.
It is.
Against
some,
every character,
sometimes you
except
crouch
sort of
cancel
Peach.
Something and get crouch canceled right back.
Yeah.
Peach,
don't
too,
crouch that much.
A few characters really love it when you crouch cancel.
Falco.
Foxes, if they're drilling a lot.
Yeah. So it's not an end-all, be-all, but it's very good. It's situationally very good.
But we're playing a fighting game at its core. Not like if you think anything is an end-all, be-all, you don't understand fighting games.
Yeah. Like even like you'll see Switch using lasers a lot, but there's still risk to that. If Gallo sees it, he can punish a laser. Actually,
yep.
It's very doable. It's just not easy.
Well, and Gallo has been. We've seen him call out a ton of lasers.
And he's
been
like caping.
Oh, he gets that back in!
Oh, and the quick ledge snap.
Nah, your combo is my combo. We're done.
And just quickly grabs that ledge to stop Switch from getting back. Really well done right there. We in the biz called it the instant ramen ledge steal.
I've literally never called it that. I think we might be in two different businesses.
You might not be in the biz.
I'm definitely a social worker. Maybe that's what you computer science guys call it.
This smash.biz. But that nice flash combo by Switch really taking that stock out. Did he crouch cancel dare into down smash?
But he was at 0%.
Yeah, I didn't even know you could crouch cancel meteors, actually. I just thought it wasn't doable.
Yeah, no. It depends on, like, the move itself. Multi-hit moves. Like, that's why foxes love doing drill, is because it does break that crouch cancel.
Ooh, and that's going to be that stock, I think.
Whereas wolves is one hit, and so you can get that crouch cancel pretty easily. Yeah, if he's at high enough percent, it'll pop him up. But at zero, you better believe you're crouch canceling that all day.
Good DI right there to live that. That was actually insane. And these wavelengths. Ooh, that back air. And
Mario's shoes come in so handy sometimes.
He's like, yo, check out these Tims. Fresh out the box.
No. Mario isn't wearing Tims, though. He's definitely wearing, like, a pair of Jordans. That's what his playstyle is dunks and, like, slams. Mario's out here playing basketball.
Yeah, you're right. Ganondorf's definitely rocking some Tims.
Yo. Ganondorf has the Tims. Mario's got those Air Force Ones.
Mario's got those new Yeezys.
I mean, shout out to the Yeezy 750 boosts, but, like, he's not wearing anything else.
Okay, so Gallo's actually down 3 stocks to 1 at, like, 20%, and has
that
brought it back.
That almost made Switch just run off stage. Not even, like, a move.
Yeah, it was just like...
It was just, I'm going to dash this way now. Stall. Okay.
Ooh, really good. That fair, not quite taking it. Next one will if Gallo misses the DI in a backstroke.
At 126, a lot of Wolf's options come into play. He has a little bit harder time comboing.
Okay, good.
Them.
He got the DI there. Yep. If he had missed that, that would have been that game.
He has a lot harder time comboing into stuff at this percent, but
this could be Switch's tournament stock right here. And this might be it.
Oh my gosh!
That DI was impeccable.
Okay, that's twice down to the ledge. If he does it one more time, Gallo better
more
be covering it. He's going for the sweet spot, but you can't if you go for the stage.
He's really scared right now.
You know what?
And he has to be. This is his tournament stock potentially. Oh my goodness!
The crowd is screaming.
Gallo has a whole nother game to play with, but Switch, this is last year.
Oh, and that is
that is
do
it. Gallo takes True King.
They hug.
Switch in second place. And surprisingly, Aiden in third place for True King.
Gallo,
an amazing tournament.
Crowned the victor.
I think a lot of people wanted Gallo to win. He has a huge fan base.
Okay, huge fan base in PM.
In PM.
So it's like at least 35.
Yeah, at least 20 people.
But real talk, follow all these guys on Twitter at Gallo Frequency.
And make sure you follow Clash Tournaments on all their types of social media.
Literally everything they do.
Twitter, YouTube. Facebook,
Hitbox,
Twitch.
Hit up their Twitch.